So where we're coming from, to me, it's the example you gave before of this focus on what's going to happen in the future. How do you see, what's your vision of that? What do I need to do to achieve such and such? You know, how can I become, you know, better at this, better at that? So the whole focus is of the majority of human beings is this idea of becoming, which probably the seed was sown the day we were asked, you know, so what do you want to be when you grow up? And I hated that question. I don't want to be anything. I definitely don't want to be grown up. So the idea that all of life, we're almost on our toes, yes, falling forwards, trying to predict how the future is going to be. You know, so I always ask people, so if you came back to really basics, what's the only absolute thing that you know with certainty that's never, ever changed throughout your life? And people have funny answers at first, and in the end, they'll come back to, well, I'm here, I exist. Yes. But when you're born, you're not born knowing your name, knowing about your body, knowing about anything other than this. And slowly that consciousness comes. Yes. So the idea of I'm here is from tiny. And then we're given descriptions of who we are. Yes. So that's the natural way of life. In any culture, no matter who we are, we're given descriptions. We're given a name. Our body is described as you. How we think is described as you. How we behave is described as you. So we then start assuming all these different identities and the conviction that we are all of these. Yes, or we're a collection of a lot of different things. Yeah. But the only thing we know for sure that's never ever changed is the sense I exist. So if that's the only thing that we know for sure, what does that say about everything else after that?
Well, it says that I'm not certain about that.
Right. Yeah.
I don't know it for sure. Yeah.
I don't know for sure anything. And yet, I've been told this, I've learned that about myself, and I've also been told I need to improve on that, I need to get rid of that, I need to, yes? And so we're all of us, no matter who we are taught that life is, so to speak, a positive pathway of accumulation and improving and becoming and focus on the future and establishing myself now, so in the future I will be secure and safe. And yeah, so everything is forward focused. But if we come back to this place of that's all I know for sure, yeah, then we can start asking. Then we already have objectivity on everything else, the way a child did. So a child, they ask fantastic questions, because they're coming from a blank slate. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So as adults, we might think, well, I'm really at a disadvantage because I just have this accumulation of knowledge about myself and life and how things should be. But no, if we just focus, hey, this is what I know for sure. And from this place, I'm going to question everything. I'm going to question particularly the one medium through which we experience the world, yes? Mm. So the mind and the senses, yeah? So exploring the mind. So often people have told me, but, you know, I prefer something that focuses on the emotions. How do we know about the emotions? How do we know about? Why not come to the very thing that seems to be a struggle for all of us? I mean, how many people have a healthy relationship with their mind? Yes. So breakthrough goes right back to basics. And it's not about philosophy anymore. It's about my direct experience. Where am I coming from? I'm coming from a place of expectation. I expect things have to have a vision, a goal, a becoming. Yes, I have to accumulate this, accumulate that. So the whole focus is coming from a place of, yeah, how the future should look, how I expect it to look, how I fear it's going to look, what I need to avoid about it. And isn't there someone here in this association that's going to lead me and guide us? And yes, so, but Breakthrough says, no, come back. Come back to your own experience. Explore for yourself. Yes. So it's very different. So that's, well, in my language would be, we're coming from a place, we're on a positive pathway, and Breakthrough is a negative pathway, which you were saying, Caroline, has all kinds of connotations. Later the other day,
yeah,
we were on our road trip, she said, but you say it's negative, and that just means bad to me.
And to so many people, because I think a lot of people are constantly trying to get rid of the negative thoughts, negative people, negative things. It's like ousting the negative and ushering in only positive. So there's like a thickly laden kind of connotation over the word negative. So I'd love for you to go into a bit more detail about what that means when you speak about it.